Alright everybody, welcome back to The Legend of Zelda The Ocarina of Time. This is probably going to be really random, because I'm pretty sure that in the last episode we were looking for the spell, which I found, but we're going to go re-get the spell, because apparently everything that I got to record, once I lost all that Kingdom Hearts stuff, this also disappeared too, so I couldn't recover the file from where I was. So I had to kind of improvise and cheat up to this point and hopefully get in there and not die. There we go. So I had to cheat to get my way back to here. And as you can see, I only have 3 hearts because I didn't give a shit. I only really need 3. But this is where you get it. And I will go into further detail on that in a sec. So pretty much what happened was the emulator decided to delete my file, so I had to restart the game if I wanted to do stuff. Why did she not? What? Right then, so she's not gonna come out because she's a pussy bitch. Cool. Well, if you guys don't know, what's supposed to happen is a fucking fairy comes out of this fountain, which is really cool, and I'm not gonna dick around for another 3 hours to try and make this happen for you, because I've already spent a good, like, 10 hours of my life doing this, and I'm sick of re-recording stuff, so the fairy's supposed to come out of the fountain, she gives you some stupid-ass spell, I think it's, like, Nairu's Love or something stupid. Pretty much what it does is it gives you extra defense or something. I'm pretty sure. And I know there's more fairy fountains than just this one and the other two, but that's all that I've found so far, and that's all that I will pretty much ever find for the most part. So she comes out of the fountain, she says the same dialogue as every other fairy except for changes what spell she has, and that's pretty much it. And the only other thing that I wanted to show you guys was the cutscene that you would have missed, because when I recovered my save, I'm probably gonna die trying to get there. But when I recovered my save, what it didn't recover was to the point where I was before. I'm so fucked. It didn't record the part before this. So you would have missed this giant ass cutscene that happens. Which I don't want you guys to miss, because it's so important. Like, you don't even know. It's the most important cutscene in the game. But yeah, you come in here, you leave. Come in here, and then you leave, and then a cutscene occurs, and it's really short and pointless, but it's still part of the game. And I'm kind of pissed that the fairy didn't come out of the fountain, but it's whatever. There's nothing I can do about it, unless I, like, actually redo the whole game, and I don't want to do that. Past, present, future. The Master Sword is a ship with which you can sail upstream and downstream through river, Times River. The port for that ship is in the Temple of Time. To restore the Desert Colossus and enter the Spirit Temple, you must travel back through time slow. Listen to the Requiem of Spirit. This melody will lead a child back to the desert. Which is actually how I got here, ironically. I used this song, this very song, to get here. That was part of my cheating. But what's gonna happen? Wow, my voice is dying. But what's gonna happen is, right after I do this and learn this song and she fucks the fuck off, I'm gonna reload my old file. And we'll probably be in the Temple of Time. And from there, we will turn into a kid and start doing stuff that was supposed to be done, like, months ago, when I was actually still recording this, so this game could have been done a long, long time ago. Let's just say that. And she disappears. Alright, so that will be it for this little tiny what happened and why and this I will show you where that spell was. Just super quick. I don't know if I'm going to add this to the recording that I'm about to record, or if I'm just going to upload this as a separate video. It really doesn't matter to me. So, that's the entrance to this place, or the Spirit Temple. If you pretty much hang... Okay. So, as you come out, you'll be facing this way, not looking at enemies. Not looking at enemies. Alright, looking at enemies. And then you take a right, and then you put a bomb right in between these two trees, and then bada bing, bada boom, you got yourself the little area to dig around in. And like I said, when you play the stupid family thing, Zelda's Lullaby, fairy comes out, spell happens, problems are all solved. So, thank you for watching, and in a couple of seconds, you will probably see me at the Temple of Time. So, get ready for that. Alright, everybody, like I said, we are in the Temple of Time now. I don't know how long that last recording was, so that may or may not be a separate video, but it doesn't really matter. All I know is we're putting this sword back in the stone, and we're getting this game the fuck done. In about probably 2 or 3 hours, because I'm pretty sure we have to do a couple of things before we can actually beat the game, but we're a kid now. We're definitely a kid. And I'll quickly show you what that spell was called. If for the people who actually do care. Still really sucks that that fairy didn't come out, or that I didn't actually get to keep the recording that I got. That would have been fantastic if that happened, but nope. Nope. Should be the blue one, I think. There you go. Costs 12 MP, and I'm pretty sure all that it does is boost your defense. That one warps you back to the start of a temple or something. That one's just... I'm pretty sure this one's defense. I'm pretty sure. I'm not 100% sure, though. Don't quote me on it. What happens if you play, like, the Song of Storms right here? I don't even know the Song of Storms anymore. Alright. Does anything happen? No. That was a waste. That was a waste of a heart and a half. So hopefully there's no more errors in recording and such from this point on. There shouldn't be. In all honesty, I don't think there's gonna be any more problems from this point on. I haven't seen you around, kid. What do you want? I'm looking for the sages. The sage. I don't know anyone like that. Alright, well, fuck you too. Same dialogue. Awesome. Nothing, really. You have nothing to do. What good timing. Can you do me a favor, kid? Wait a second. I want to ask you first. You wouldn't happen to be, there we go, one of Ganondorf's followers, would you? I hate Ganondorf, there you go. Uh-huh. You've got guts. I think I like you. First of all, let me introduce myself. I am Naburu, or something along those lines. Of the Gerudo. I'm a lone wolf thief. But don't get me wrong. Though we're both thieves, I'm completely different from Ganondorf. With his followers, he stole from women and children, and he even killed people. Good for him. A kid like you may not know this, but Ganondorf's race consists of only women. Only one man is born every 100 years. How was that man born? He must have some crazy-ass sex. That's all I'm gonna say. Even though our laws say that lone male Ganondorf must become king of the Gerudo, I'll never bow to such an evil man. By the way, what is your name, kid? Nerdiaq. What kind of name is that? Well, anyway. I want to ask you a favor. Will you go through this hole and get a treasure that's inside? The treasure is the silver gauntlets. If you equip them, you can easily push and pull very heavy things. No, 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 kid. Don't even think about taking the this treasure for yourself. Silver gauntlets won't fit a little kid like you. If you try to equip them, I want you to be a good boy and give them to me. Ganondorf and his minions are using the Spirit Temple as a hideout. Only the silver gauntlets will allow me to sneak deep into the temple. Once there, I'm going to steal all of the treasure inside and mess up their plans. How about it? Will you do it? Yes. Thanks, kid. You and I, let's give Ganondorf and his followers a big surprise, shall we? If you can successfully get the silver gauntlets, I'll do something great for you. Awesome. I'm a little bit young for that, but it's okay. Don't even worry. Wow. Oh, my shield's gone! Son of a bitch! You asshole bats! Why? That thing cost me like 40 bucks! You know how much that is? That's quite a bit for me. I'm pressing the wrong button. That's why he's not swinging. Son of a bitch, get over here. Die. Thank you. Seeds aren't really that great. Alright. Huh. Perfect. Awesome. Do I know what I'm doing? No. I do know that I lost my shield, though, and that kind of sucks. This place may or may not confuse the living shit out of me. Just so you guys know, there might be a lot of confusion and yelling at this game. Because I don't remember the Spirit Temple one bit, especially not as a kid. Wow, there's like, the floor is on crack over here, apparently. Alright, bitch. You want to turn around so I can poke you in the butt? Wow, I can't poke him in the butt. Apparently I can't poke him in the butt. There you go. What? I was gonna say. Couldn't have done that better if I did that like four times. Yeah, there's like a weird floor over here. Well, whatever. We're going through this door. Or not. Okay. Oh, actually, wait. Oh. We do have arrows. I mean, we have magic. We have arrows too, just can't use them as a kid. That's why that stumped me for a second. I was like, what? Son of a bitch. I hate this right now. Why do I have to switch items so much? Oh, fuck. Well, there's a Skulltula, which probably really isn't that necessary anymore.